Good morning and welcome to Sensory Cooking. Today we are going to work on making s'mores bars. I don't know what it is in your neck of the woods. The weather's getting good to make s'mores here. For a lot of you in summer, it's probably more of a campfire food, but this one's great because you can make it in your house. We're going to follow the same rules we always do. We are going to review our recipe, wash our hands, make sure our hair is back if it's longer than mine, or probably about my length. And then we're going to get going. Now, for this one, we are going to consider auditory processing as part of our language goals. So as our auditory sensory goal, we're going to go through the steps of this recipe. So our ingredients are all assembled, and what we're going to do is butter the pan, and then in a large saucepan, we are going to combine the corn syrup and the butter. Then we're going to remove it from the heat once it's melted. Then we'll add the chocolate chips and vanilla. Stir until the chocolate is melted. Then we will add the cereal, which is like a graham cracker cereal. And we'll fold in the marshmallows because we don't want them to get squished or melted. Then we'll take the cereal mixture and we'll put it into a greased pan. We'll pat it down and once it sets, it can be cut and eaten. You don't even have to bake it. It's quick and delicious and a lot of fun for the kids and a little sticky. So we're gonna start by greasing a 9x13 pan. Literally just a little bit of butter on a paper towel or a piece of wax paper works fine. Make sure you get the corners and the edges. If we were baking a cake and we had a grease and flour, we'd just add a little bit of flour and kind of tip it in all directions to get it around and then dump out what was left. But greasing, when that's all you have to do, is pretty simple. We've got it covered. So we're putting together our sauce, kind of, or glaze for our s'mores bars. And that's going to be corn syrup, and butter. Traditional corn syrup's not like the corn syrup they use in highly sweetened things that they make now. That's a newer product. So once we get our butter and our corn syrup melted, we need a big pan because what has to fit in here in addition to all these little ingredients is the cereal and the marshmallows, and that's going to take up a lot more room. So this is kind of fun and sticky, but what you'll see is as it heats up, it isn't as sticky as it was. So cold corn syrup is pretty sticky. Once it gets hot, it's runnier. So heat changes things. Once we get that melted up, then we're going to add our chocolate chips and our vanilla. And after that, we're going to go and back over to the counter and put in our graham cracker cereal and our marshmallows. So now, chocolate chips. It calls for milk chocolate. I added just a sprinkle of dark chocolate, actually semi-sweet, because I like a little richer flavor. So we're gonna add all that. And at this point, our bourbon goes off. And we're gonna add the vanilla, 1 teaspoon. I've switched to a whisk now. And once that's all melted, which is only going to take a second, we're going to take it back over to the counter and add our other ingredients. Okay, so this is melted. Now we're going to add our graham cracker cereal. Stir that a little before we add the marshmallows because we want it to start to cool off before we put the marshmallows in. The cereal won't melt, the marshmallows will. It's kind of fun to hear the crunch, but we don't want to, we still want to be sort of gentle because we don't want this to turn into little crumbs. It should still look and taste like a s'more. We're gonna put our marshmallows in. And we're gonna keep stirring it up We're gonna get all that chocolate off the bottom. And try to keep our stuff in the bowl. And then once it's mixed, and everything's pretty, oops, sorry, evenly coated, we are gonna put it in our pan. Which is already greased and ready to go. Now you have two options once you get to this point. You can flatten it with a spatula, or if your kids think it's fun, get your fingers in there. This isn't hot enough that it's gonna burn anybody at this point. So it's just fun to kind of squish it down with your hands. And they got some sensory action going on, but it's chocolate and marshmallows, so it's great. And then once that's all squished in, you got to push it down a little bit or it's not going to become dense enough to be a bar. So they can push a little, they just don't want to crush all the cereal. So see, we still have it looking pretty much like cereal, but we've kind of packed it down in to make sure it's going to be a bar when we cut it. We're going to let this cool, and they'll be ready to eat probably in half an hour. That's what makes it kind of a fun treat. It's really quick, and they get immediate gratification. And that's it, s'mores bars.